Welcome to my channel focused on movement and function. I'm Beth. In today's video, I'll be sharing a lot of helpful information about sleep position using pillow supports and types of mattresses and pillows in order to help you get the best night's sleep possible. So let's start off with mattresses. What type of mattress is best? Everybody's body is different in terms of how soft or how firm the mattress needs to be to support our bodies. In general, the idea is that we want a mattress that's firm enough to support our alignment so that our spine and all of our joints are in good alignment without sagging too much or being overstretched. Secondly, we want enough comfort and softness to spread out the pressure of our body on the bed so that the parts of our body, which is usually kind of the bony areas, our shoulders, our hips, side of our knee, to not feel pressure points. So we want to be able to spread out our body on the surface and feel supported all around. Now with pillows, it's also a very individualized decision as to how much support and how much comfort you need. In general, the pillow should naturally take up the space of the curve in the back of your neck when you're sleeping on your back, or this curve in the side of your neck if you're sleeping on your side. What's tricky for a lot of people if you toss and turn and sleep in different positions is that the amount of support you need can change throughout the night. Typically, we need more support when we're sleeping on our side, less support when we're sleeping on our back. And then sleeping on our stomach, that's kind of a whole different ballgame that I'll talk about a little bit later. In terms of types of pillow, there are a couple things to consider. Typically, the standard pillow that's really fluffy in the middle and tapers off on the edge is really not so great because that means there's the most support in the middle, which is where the head is, and less support on the edge, which is actually where our neck is. Most of us need more support here and less support here. So many people feel much better with a pillow that's shaped inverted. So it's actually bigger on the ends and a little bit shallower in the middle. Okay, so this type of pillow has two different size kind of bumps. One would be for somebody that's a little bit smaller, where there's less space between their shoulder and their neck. And then this bigger end is for somebody who is a little bit bigger and needs more support. Ideally, your head rests right here in the middle. Now, if this idea sounds like something you want to try, one way to do that before you invest in a new pillow is to use a towel roll. You'll want to take a hand towel, fold it in half, and then roll it up. Try to get the wrinkles out because you're going to be sleeping on this. And then put a couple hair ties, rubber band, whatever you have around the house, around this towel roll. You might need to try different size rolls in order to find the one that works best for you. Now you'll place this towel roll on the bottom edge of the pillowcase, just like this, and then go ahead and put the pillowcase back down. So now there's this sort of lump or bump in the bottom of my pillow. And when you lie down, let me switch these pillows around. So when you lie down, you'll have this extra firm towel roll here. You want this to fit in the back of your neck if you're lying on your back, or the side of your neck if you're lying on your side. This is a great hotel hack. I've done this many times, staying in hotels that have pillows that really don't match what I need. I will take an extra towel roll and roll it up in here. So try that out. If that feels like a good idea to you, keep using it. Or it might also be an indication that you would benefit from an ergonomic pillow like I showed you. Okay, let's talk about sleep position. Oftentimes people want to know which sleep position is best. There really isn't any one best sleep position for everybody. It really varies person to person. But there are some key components to consider with each type of sleep position. So let's go through those one at a time. First of all, back sleeping. So let's talk about what's involved there, starting at the neck. I already mentioned pillow support, so I'll leave this pillow here, and when I lie down, you'll be able to see where I place my neck. The other component of sleeping on the back is making sure that you have adequate support for your lower body. Oftentimes when people lie on their back, they feel strained because their back ends up being arched. In that case, you want to put a pillow or some type of support underneath your knees. So that's what this one will end up being used for. You could try a standard size pillow. If that feels like too much, you might want to try a decorator pillow, so a small kind of couch pillow, that type of thing. So let's look at that. Okay, lying on my back, I've positioned myself so that the curve of my neck is right over the top of this towel roll. So I can feel very lightly the edge of the towel against my neck. It's not pushing my neck up, but it's also supporting my neck so that it doesn't become too flat. All right, and this feels like I have pretty adequate support underneath my head. We want to have enough support so that our head is in line with the neck and the entire spine. So we want to have enough support that our head isn't tilted down, but it's also not too much support to where your head is pushed up. Now moving down the chain to your low back and your legs. I mentioned using a pillow under your knees to avoid overarching and straining your back. This helps to relax the back and allow your back to flatten gently into the bed. Let's move on to side sleeping. And when I make this transition, I want to show you a little hack that I learned a long time ago to shift the position of the pillows. So if I'm lying on my back with the pillow underneath my knees and I roll over onto my side, one thing I can do is as I roll, I'm simply going to reach down to the edge of the pillow and pull it in between my knees. This is a fantastic way to achieve good support for between your knees in order to keep your hips aligned. And if you just do that little pull motion, then you're not wrestling with your pillow all night long. Takes a little bit of practice to get that one down, but soon enough, it'll feel comfortable for you. On our side, as I mentioned before, we want to have the pillow support at the base of the neck. You don't want it under your shoulder or underneath your head. You want it under the crook of your neck. And it should just take up the natural space. It shouldn't be so thick that it pushes your neck up. Now on our side, we want to have neutral alignment of our head, neck, and spine. Too little pillow support and the head tends to sag. And too much pillow support, the head ends up angled too high. And at the hips, probably the most ideal position is to have your knees stacked. That way your hips are supported and there is neutral alignment between your hips, your pelvis, and your lumbar spine. Oftentimes on our sides, there's a tendency for one leg to come forward and we end up in this twisted position like this. For some, if that's comfortable for you, great. For a lot of people, this torque is enough to really aggravate hip, pelvis, sacroiliac, lumbar spine issues. So keeping that pillow tucked between the knees is a great way to avoid that. Last but not least is stomach sleeping. So let's ditch this pillow and I'll roll over onto my stomach. I'll also ditch the towel roll. We don't need that for stomach sleeping. Stomach sleeping tends to decrease with age, typically because our low backs really don't like to be in this arched position as we get older. We tend to see a lot more kids and young adults sleeping on their stomach than we do in middle age and older years. But let's still go over this, just in case this is a position that is comfortable for you. A lot of stomach sleepers end up not needing any pillow at all, or a very flat pillow. One thing that can work well is to actually use the edge of the pillow. So while I'm on my stomach, I may actually have the side of my head just on the edge of the pillow. That way I have some support for my head and my neck, but I'm also able to breathe freely. I hope the information in this video has given you something to try and explore in order to find the best possible sleeping position and support structures for your body. I would be interested in hearing how things go for you, so please feel free to leave a comment or question down below. Also, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and click the bell if you want to be notified when I release my next video. It's always great to see a thumbs up too. Here's to getting a great night's sleep and your overall health and happiness. Have a great day.